Hi, I'm Gaylerd. Welcome back to Big DAWG Acoustic Guitar Series. Hey, in this lesson, you're going to learn the very first set of notes that you're going to use to create riffs, fills, and transitions. And this one's from the E minor chord. Now, I'm going to put the notes on the screen for you right now. Take a look at those notes. All right, now let me play those notes for you real quick. It goes like this. Now, that is not a scale. It doesn't even sound like a scale, right? But you don't use it as a scale. Those are the notes that you're going to use when you're ready to create, when you're playing a little E minor. You'll use those notes. You can use them in any pattern, any positions. Take this note from the top, change it with the bottom note. It doesn't matter what notes that you pick, but those are the notes that you'll use for riffs, fills, and transitions to other chords. For instance, if you were going to transition to a C chord, okay, you can use any one of those notes. I'm going to use these bottom notes here because they're easy to follow for you, but I'm going to change into a C chord. The key is this, use any one of those notes. As long as when you get ready to play your chord, the first note you play is the bass note or the root note of the chords you're changing to. So in other words, in a C, if you look at your scale, we can play the open 5, 2 on 5, open 4, 2 on 4, right? But when I come back to that C, I got to make sure that I'm hitting that C note, that root C in the chord. You can do one of two things. You can hit the note and then hit the chord, or you can go ahead and play the full chord itself. Like this. Okay, I hit that note right there, or you can just do the chord. Okay, now I used a G bass on that, and that's fine as long as you're hitting that note, as long as that note is prominent when you come back to switch that chord. But you can just as easily from the E minor. Those notes are in there, right? So you can do any of those notes in any pattern as long as you get there. Let's say that you were going to a G. Okay, I'm still using the, I just like using those bass notes, but you don't need to do that all the time. A lot of times you want to go a, you could do that, go to a G. Any one of those notes that are in that, on that tab, you can use in any pattern to change to a chord. Now, are there other notes that you can play? Sure, there are. These are the notes that you're going to use most commonly. You may want to throw in an extra note, and if it sounds good, keep it. If it doesn't, don't use it. Pretty simple. But those are the notes. So here's what I want you to do. It's going to be important that you learn these notes so that you can transition, because as you are going to do an E minor, then we're going to do an A minor next. But pretty soon, you're going to be putting all of these little riff patterns into songs and the chords that you change. So you want to make sure that you learn each chord's note. So here's what you want to do. I want you to be able to play all of those notes with different fingers, and here are starting with different fingers. For instance, the easiest one to use is your middle finger on this particular riff. So it'd be like this. I'm not using my middle finger up here. I switched it to use my index and middle finger. That's fine as long as you start off with the middle finger on this one. You want to use different fingers for that. Then I want you to use your index finger. And the reason you do this depends on what chord patterns you're using, depends on the chord that you're getting ready to change to. You're going to need to use different fingers on your riffs so you can change to that chord. So I want you to be able to use different fingers on it. Now, if you start off with your index finger on this, we're going to be changing to our middle finger to do a slide. Watch this. See that slide right there? I switched to my middle finger because it's easier for me to use that slide right there. And I can switch off. As long as you start off with your middle finger and your index finger, whatever other fingers you use, that's up to you. Make it comfortable for you. You may want to throw in your pinky. Okay? Use different fingers to get those notes. Don't go on until you're able to play all of those notes with your middle finger, starting with your middle finger, starting with your index. Look, I even use my pinky to get to that note there, and your ring finger. Those three fingers right there is your beginning notes. You can change on the fifth string, you can change fingers, do whatever you want, but make sure you start with that pattern with each one of those fingers. Make sure you're able to do that before you move on and to the next lesson. So get that down smooth, and I'll see you in the next video.